Thank you. I think all the presentations had very different focuses, and my focus is more on the contextualization of the issue regarding Hungary. So to start with, Hungary is not, as the other Central Eastern European countries, is not an immigrant country. It's so Islamophobia, that we identified as Islamophobia, is basically a new phenomenon. It's primarily linked to the 2015 refugee crisis. So that was a time when Islamophobia or Islamophobic narratives came to the surface. So the low rate of immigration and the low, even lower rate of migrants with Muslim background makes the case very different from other regions of Europe. It's estimated the number of the Muslim population or population with Muslim background is estimated between 25,000 to 50,000, and actually part of it, or maybe the majority of it, is converted Hungarians. So as I said, it was the 2015 refugee crisis when the whole issue came to the surface and became a political issue. And it was mainly part of the government, the populist government's propaganda to talk about anti-immigration, basically. So there was the main narrative was a securitization, a security narrative of migration or immigration. And it was not on the surface or on one level. It was not not linked to Islam. That's, I think, it's an important point. But it was linked to terrorism. So basically, the refugee crisis was framed as an illegal migration process and also as a threat of terrorism. But on another level, we actually saw the rise of anti-Islam narratives. So obviously linked to this situation. And that was the level when securitization of Islam appeared, and the main narrative, as I said, it was basically the government narrative. It was the Islamization of Europe, loss of and the loss of Christian and European and Hungarian identities. So that was the main message, or is the main message still the main message? And Hungary is positioned as a defender of the Christian Europe, so these are the main issues. So, and then there is another another point that this verse pointing out, that there is a double speech. So on the one hand, Hungary, so as I said, there is this securitization of Islam appearing. But on the other hand, as Hungary has a foreign policy of opening up to Eastern countries, including lots of Muslim countries, so there is also this political narrative of the appreciation of Islam. But then the other sub narrative of this narrative is that, okay, we appreciate Islam as long as it stays outside of Europe. So this is like a very brief summary of the main narratives of Islamophobia, and as I said, it's mainly generated by the governments, and actually the far right, having very similar narratives, they are. They are not the main propagators or not the main generators of this narrative. So concerning the regarding the counter narratives, in general, the counter voices are weak in Hungary at the moment, related to the oppression of freedom of press, freedom of speech. Basically, they are less and less spaces for counter voices on any issues, but that's obviously the case with voicing counter arguments, counter narratives of anti-immigrant or anti-immigration and anti-Islamophobic Islamophobic narratives. So those narratives which actually appear coming from opposition parties, coming from civil society, they are basically focusing focusing on differentiating between legal and illegal migration and radical and non-radical Islam. And there are many other subcategories, but I think these are the main strategies. So just to sum up, I think what is very important that this Islamophobia in the Hungarian context at the moment should be understood as part of the populist discourse. And the populist government is the main conveyor of this discourse. And also the other important issue is that it's part of a broader anti-migration discourse, and this is the dominant political rhetoric at the moment in the country. And as I said, counter voices are weak. So they are weak to counter any issues. They are weak to counter anti-Muslimism as well, and I think the main issue in Hungary is that how can we counter populism? So this is my final note, and this is where I would like to stop. Thank you very much.